Hello and welcome to this episode of the Worship Band Builder Podcast, where we are working with you to lay the foundation for skillful worship. I'm Eric Roberts, and this is my co-host, Emily Roberts.
Hello, everybody.
And today we're going to be talking about the piece of gear every acoustic guitar player needs.
Ooh, is it a guitar?
Yes. If you are a guitar player, you need a guitar. This is going to be sort of like, I don't know if you want to call this the Worship Band Builder short stuff, but for the next three episodes, we're doing shorter, potent stuff. This one is acoustic guitar. Okay, so if you're an acoustic guitar player, for example, one of my buddies that is in ministry up north texted me, said, hey, I'm trying to, what do I do? What do I get for my acoustic guitar? And I was thinking, oh yeah, I know why he's asking that, because if you just take your acoustic guitar like everybody does and you just plug it straight into the, you know, direct box and right into your mixer, it can be jangly. That's the problem. So we're going to outline a problem, a solution, and show you several ways you can fix it.
So this episode is how to fix your jangly guitar.
You got jangly guitar tone? You need to fix it.
I think that may be an Eric original. I'm not sure that's a real word, but I like it.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, I don't know. Jangly is kind of always haunting you if you have an acoustic and you're plugging in just to a direct box. And in past episodes, we've talked about how to play softer, you know, because a lot of jangly guitar tone comes from just beating on the guitar. So if you're watching my lessons or doing my online school, you're gonna hear me a lot like light pick, you know, soft strumming, so you get good tone. That's really the key. But there's a piece of gear that can help you, and that's the problem. You got weak tone, no volume control, you can't turn it up, it's thin, it's jangly. And the solution is, are you ready for it?
Wait for it.
What would you think it was? I mean, you have notes, but
well, let me see. It's going to be some little plug your guitar into something thingy.
Yeah, okay. She's
right? I'm right.
All right, so it is a multi-effects pedal on the acoustic. So that's the solution. Go into something before you go into the direct box, and I'll talk about my favorites, and I'm going to show you a simple way that I do it. I've got some pedals on the table today. These are for the electric guitar session, but they're going to sit there just to be pretty for now.
And for those who are just listening, you'll have links to these things?
Yeah, actually, I put a whole new page up on worshipbandbuilder.com/gear, and everything we talk about from now on in our podcast is on that page. worshipbandbuilder.com/gear.
Ooh, handy. Okay?
Also, if you want to, since we're doing that, you can also now donate to worshiptheking.com. Become a partner, a ministry partner, whether you're going to join our monthly subscription service there so you get some like free stuff, or whether you're going to join for free, we have that. But we'd like you to consider partnering with us. You can go to worshiptheking.com/partner, and you can give one-time gift, you can give a monthly gift, and that really just helps our ministry as we are just cranking it up in production. So there are a lot of the videos we do, and a lot of the resources we give are free resources. Probably 50 to 75% of the resources we have are pretty much free. So consider that. I'll leave that on the screen for you if you want. And if you're watching on YouTube, you can also support us just by sharing this with your friends, Facebook, that helps a lot. All right, so a multi-effects pedal on the acoustic guitar. You can do this. You really just, like, for example, I have a Line 6 Pod X3 Live. Okay, that's a big pedal. When I got it, it was pretty expensive. Now you can get them on eBay for like $100, okay? Now, just because it's an electric guitar effects processor doesn't mean you can't plug your acoustic into it. A lot of them do both. So really what you need on an acoustic, here's several ways you can do it. You can use a real-life pedal board. So this is the first more advanced model version of this. Get a pedal board, put a tuner on it, you put a compressor on it, and you put a reverb on it, okay? And then you plug your guitar into that. Now you've got a little tuner that you can tune to, which is probably the most important thing. And then you have a little compressor, and compressors are good for acoustic guitar. And all of my pedals are listed on that sheet. And then a reverb. If you just had compression and reverb on your acoustic, it would change a ton. So you'd want a little bit of reverb, a little bit of compression. It just gives your signal that little bit of sweetness, takes away that simple direct box in. We're going to talk in these next several episodes about just going direct in a direct box is terrible. It's a terrible idea. I mean, we all do it, but it, just if you take a few minutes to fix something to where you have a little bit of volume control, maybe treble bass control, maybe level control, then you got a little reverb on there, your acoustic guitar is going to open up. So that's the first way to do it. Make up a little pedal board, you know, buy individual pedals, and I have all those recommendations. Or what I found for my friend when I shot him a link, and I don't know if he got this yet, but it's a Zoom. It is a Zoom multi-effects acoustic. It's made for an acoustic, and it's a little multi-effects processor. It has like delay, reverb. It has everything in it. So one little box, I think it's about $100, and it has everything in it. It does everything. So you don't have to have a bunch of pedals. You can just plug that in. It's probably got a little preamp in it. It's probably got a little compressor, a little delay, a little reverb. And then you can just tweak your sound. It's got little sound banks you can save them in. Does that make sense?
Yes. Is this way easier?
Yeah, it really is more. It's easier. It's more. It's flexible. It's inexpensive. Okay,
so I was just going to ask. That was my next question. Is it less expensive than having the three separate pedals and the board?
By about a third. So each one of the pedals I would probably suggest to you are about $100 a piece. You know, like a reverb pedal is like $150. So this multi-effects unit is like $100 total. So you're talking about a third of the cost or a quarter of the cost.
Is the quality and the flexibility as good?
Yeah. You know, I mean, multi-effects processors have come so far. I mean, I've been using them since the 90s, and I'm sure that before that they were even out. But it really is... They've come really far, okay, really far. So when you buy one pedal, like if you buy this one little pedal here, this can be anywhere from $80 to $150. You know, it's going to do one thing. It's going to maybe give you reverb, or it's going to give you compression, but it's not going to give you, you know, a multi-effects processor that you buy for $100, $125 from Zoom is going to give you everything. Now, some of you guys out there, like really like tone nerds, are going to be like, you know, not into that. But if you're at that level, you're probably not watching this trying to get advice like, oh, how should I do this? So some guys will spend $400 on one pedal, $600 on one pedal, you know, just for their overdrive. I was looking up a pedal the other day that I want to get, and it's like $400, you know. So I've found ways to cut corners, like through Behringer, which makes pedals that are basically the same exact, they're like knockoff pedals, but they're really phenomenal. And instead of like $400, you can get them for like $40. Okay, so a lot of my pedals are in that range. Because, you can spend, you know, a couple thousand dollars on electric guitar pedals, easy. And still, the multi-effects unit processors, even the cheap ones, are good. And once you plug everything in and turn it on, it isn't like anybody's going to run up and be like, did you pay $2,000 for that acoustic sound? I mean, most people are just not going to know. So I use what I can afford, what I can get, what's versatile, instead of just trying to, you know, be like I'm a tone snob or like a pedal snob, you know, pedal snob, like, oh, I've got this like $600 handmade pedal. If you have that kind of money and you really want to study it, that's totally cool, but that's not relevant to like every single person out here on a budget trying to up their game a little bit.
Sure. Okay.
So my friend, when he emailed me, I could have said like, yeah, you can buy these seven pedals that cost, you know, $1,800. And he would have been like, what are you, crazy? Mm-hmm. He just wanted to get a little bit better. Okay.
Well, it sounds to me like in addition to being less expensive and at least nearly as effective, this is probably much easier to transport, yes?
Oh, yeah. Pedal boards are a pain. You got to buy a case for them. You got to have all these extra plug-ins. You know, one of these multi-effects processors, you just carry it up there, plug it in one plug, set it on the ground. You can throw it. That's why guys like them. So if you're in that range of, if you're the guy plugging right into your direct box and you're thinking, I want to get a little bit better, this multi-effects pedal is the way to go. A couple $100 or less. For this Zoom thing, I'll put the link in there. So how you plug it in was, and we'll do this for the ending here, you would take your guitar, you'd plug it into, this is not the acoustic one, but you would take your effects processor and you'd plug it into the input, and then you would take your output and you would plug it into your direct box, and then you have a little bit of whatever the controls are there. Some of these pedals, like this one, actually has a direct box out, so you can actually get away with not even having a direct box. That's another good thing. Some of the pedals have direct out, XLR out, so that you plug in. Actually, both of these pedals on the table have that. You can plug This would be the final chain, and you wouldn't need a direct box. You would go right out of this into, you know, you would not. So they work as a direct box. Some of them work as a direct box as well. So you can knock that piece of gear off the stage, and you just plug your XLR cable right into the end of your chain. And so your guitar goes into this pedal, and then either it goes into a direct box or the XLR cable goes right into that, and that goes straight up to the mixer, and then you have all this flexibility.
So the multi-effects processor is like lip gloss for your tone.
Yeah. It's lip gloss for your tone. Lip gloss for your tone. And I'm endorsing this Zuma. Now, I've never tried it. I've never tried this exact pedal. But the thing is, guys, if you buy this on Amazon, you have, I don't know how long their return policy is, but I do that. I buy something, and if I don't like it, I just stick it in the box, and a week later, I just send it back. They give you your money back. So if you're, that's what I would do. I would use the Amazon. Their kindness is crazy, because you can just literally, for free, try the pedal and on Amazon, and then if you don't like it, you just stick it back in, take it to UPS. So, you know, it's not going to hurt you to try this. You can plug it in at church, use it, just keep all the pedal, keep all the, like, the receipts and keep the little packaging. Like, don't be a jerk and throw that all away and then not be able to return it. But, you know, just keep it nice, like you're going to keep all your gear anyway.
Word for the day.
Don't be a jerk.
Don't be a jerk.
Don't be a jerk. All right. So, yeah, make sure you check this out. Like I said, worshipbandbuilder.com/gear. All of my gear is on there that I've been using, and some of the stuff that I haven't been using but I know is really good. You cannot go wrong with Zoom. We use a Zoom mixer. Zoom has been around since I was a teenager. They've been killing it. They've always had great tone, and I really am glad they brought out this little Zoom A14 acoustic multi-effects processor. It is inexpensive, and I'm pretty sure it's going to sound way better than your direct in, and then you're going to have a lot of control, and at the end of the day, just don't strum too hard. And put a little reverb, a little compression, and then you've got a really good or better
lip gloss.
Lip gloss for your guitar tone. Make sure you share this. We'll see you on the next episode.